I guess my journey began last May when I attended the First Nation Métis Inuit teacher camp at the Jasper Palisades, which was put on by, I think it was the Grand Yellowhead School Division. And that's where I met Solange. And I was quite new. I had just started with Aboriginal Learning Services with Edmonton Catholic that fall, so in November. So actually pretty much the beginning of December was when I started. And at the time, my role wasn't distinct. I wasn't the First Nation Métis Inuit Social Studies consultant then. So going to the teacher camp, really when I learned about the project and when I met other people, I really felt I really wanted to stay where I was. And so I reapplied to stay in the department. And so when I was granted this role in the fall, when we were, you know, planning for our teachers to put on some professional development sessions, right away I thought of Solange because she had introduced us to the FNMI blogspot, and I was really interested in, you know, learning how to navigate through the site and being able to provide these resources for our district teachers. So in order for me to collaborate with Solange, Karen Aggie has suggested and invited us to join the project, even though it was in its last year. So I was very happy to be able to join and to be able to work with Solange. And so I guess my journey is because I'm also new in, you know, being responsible for providing resources for our teachers and providing them and helping them to feel empowered and that they can deliver the First Nation, Métis, Inuit perspectives in their classroom, I really thought it was a great partnership. So we started. We started to work together. She gave us ideas on, you know, kind of like our first PD. So we invited all our schools, we have 89 schools, to provide a contact person, which would be our lead teacher, who is invited to come to our monthly professional learning sessions and then be that contact for the rest of the teachers at their school. And so to begin with, we wanted to see where our teachers were at with their own knowledge when it came to First Nation, Métis, Inuit education. And we found that they really didn't feel like they knew that much about you know, how to deliver those perspectives. So we spent a PD session which we used Our Way is a Valid Way. And so we kind of did a jigsaw activity where we had the teachers explore different topic areas like traditional storytelling, anti-racism, residential schools, and I think it was learning on the land, or I can't remember, land in the people maybe it was. And so after that session, the teachers that did agree to be the lead teachers did so voluntary. So a lot of our teachers don't have assigned time to be this lead teacher to take on this role. And I feel like they already had that feeling that of a passion for this education. So I felt like I felt lucky that I had teachers that were willing to and they wanted to deliver this knowledge back to their school sites. So I think we started off on a real positive note. And then so we continued. We continued every month to provide PD, which aligned with curricular outcomes, focusing mostly in the social studies areas. So anywhere from K to 12. So we helped, I would contact Solange and she would direct me which resources would be the best ones. And then we started to reach out to our community because I learned through Solange and the project that especially in that component of learning to relate, that reaching out to our communities is key. And so going beyond, because I myself didn't have that knowledge either. So we went to our elders. We have a council of elders. We reached out to our community people. For example, former Chief of Enoch came and hosted, co-facilitated the Understanding the Treaties PD that we put on. And then we had our elder Jerry Wood join us for moving beyond residential schools and sharing his stories. And we would have for our Inuit PD, Minnie, our elder, so sweet, who grew up in an Inuit community, come share her stories. So we would have that, and I think our teachers felt very empowered and very honored that we were able to provide them with these connections. A lot of our teachers requested elders to come to their classrooms, and so we were able to also provide that support. We would have people from, let's say, the Musée Heritage Museum, Sharon Morin, who's Métis and kind of an expert in her people. And so she came and spoke to her teachers and provided resources and even just shared with her teachers like some of the things that they could bring their kids on field trips to and just everything that could really support the First Nation Métis and Inuit education in our classrooms. So I guess I really like the model of the project. It took me probably till the third time I met with Solange to really understand what learning to be meant and what learning to know meant, what learning to do means. I did get the relational part first, learning to relate, but it did take me a while to kind of be able to understand that the shift that fits in really well with our own district, we call it transform. And so we are focusing on pedagogical shifts where we go from just, you know, delivering lessons and kind of focusing on low level thinking to the higher Bloom's taxonomy where it's inquiry. And I really like the way Solange had aligned these projects with the ministerial order and everything was just very, she's just done an amazing job, so I was able to connect with it and the way that it was laid out. So once I met with her and figured that out, I felt empowered and I felt like I was able to bring these concepts to our teachers so that they could feel confident and ready to deliver them in their classrooms. So I guess I just feel lucky that we were able to be a part of it, and being able to bring 10 of our lead teachers from all our different schools with a very good representation of elementary, junior high, high school, and I think we had two of our assistant principals join me for this spring gathering. They all feel very honored at the opportunity. So I think it makes us reflect on ourselves as a district as well, that we feel very innovative, I guess, when we have that question, what does innovation look like? To me, I feel it looks like moving forward, and it looks like, you know, looking at the situation we're in and then finding creative solutions to be able to bring this education to our educators and build capacity within our district, and having them feel empowered and not having this being delegated to them. So I think those are really key aspects. And I felt like, you know, if it wasn't for this project and being part of it, I probably wouldn't have been able to do that. I don't think I would have been able, I wouldn't have known how to do that with our teachers. So I guess I just feel very honored and grateful that we were part of it. So say thank you.